اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد. I repeat. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد. Once again. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد. Okay, before we go into what this means and how we say it, let's take a quick look at where we say it. So if you recall, we were looking at this chart, and this said that when you're ending the prayer, you would go and perform this on page 28. So as we end the prayer, we're sitting in that final sitting to end the prayer. First, we will start with this tashahhud, right? As we discussed last time. Okay, if you're continuing the prayer, we'd say the tashahhud and we'd get up. If you're not continuing the prayer, if it's the last unit, then we would continue saying this, which as the PDF says, is on page 28. So we'll go to page 28, and this is what we are working on right now. I will make around 4 episodes of this, inshallah, God willing, and that will wrap it up. One quick thing I wanted to share in, say, in this document, I've also included a link to the playlist here. So this is actually a video, because right now we're just working on what you say, right? But how do you move, how do you sit, and all that sort of stuff is all explained in this playlist here. So you should be able to access it from this document as well. Okay, so let's come back to it, what this means, and so on and so forth. Okay, so this is us now asking Allah to send the prayers, which means to raise the mention. Okay, to raise the mention and mentioning the Prophet Muhammad among the noble angels and so on and so forth. So when we do that, we ask Allah to do this for our Prophet Muhammad. Allah says, you know, paraphrasing, we have it from what we know from the Prophet, that we would get it 10 more times from Allah. So we ask Allah once, Allah give us 10 times. Okay. So this is something really, really valuable. And as you learn in your other courses, there are so many blessings and impact of saying this. So making this dua, making this, asking Allah for this, for the Prophet, helps us a lot in our own lives and our own situations, our own worries and our own circumstances immensely. So this is a very good way of making dua to Allah, asking Allah. Even outside of prayer, you can just say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Even that itself is a very useful way of remembering and mentioning Allah outside of the prayer as well. Okay. And this is kind of related to whenever we say the name of Prophet Muhammad, we say this, you know, sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. So you may have heard some Muslims saying this. So this is, you can say it that way or this way. It's the same meaning phrased in different ways. So if you get this, you can say that, you know, for example, if you're saying Muhammad, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad is my role model. Okay. So whenever you mention the name of our Prophet, you can say this in this fashion as well. I would like to learn more about Muhammad, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Okay. So this is another way of saying it as well. Anyways, coming back to our topic. So you are saying this for Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as well as the family of Prophet Muhammad. And then later on, you will see that how we are saying this, mentioning the Prophet Abraham as well and his family, which would also include other prophets, right? Prophet Moses, Jesus, peace be upon them all, and so on and so forth. Because in Islam, as you know, that we believe and respect and honor all the prophets and messengers of Allah. Okay, so let's break it down. Allahumma. Okay, I haven't, you know, broken down the syllables because now you should be able to get more and more together. Allahumma. Allahumma, which means, O Allah. So many du'as, when you're asking Allah, it would start with this. Allahumma. Salli. Salli. Ala. Muhammad. Wa. Ala. Ali Muhammad. Okay, so Al here, this means family. Okay, because you will see these words repeated a lot in this whole prayer. Okay, so that's it. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Ali Muhammad. So I'll see you in the next one.